Oh, Jesus. These must be the tentacles we heard about.
So the rumors were true. Are they Jenna's too?
We'll know for sure when we get her back to the station. Let's hurry up and catch her.
Jeez. Anything to get away from that stink. salutations. Browse my wares, should it please? Very well, then. I shall eagerly await your...
Ha ha ha! now the Arm Legion resurfaces. It appears they seek out their previous masters somehow. Perhaps by instinct. This behavior warrants further study. Be sure to bring the Arm Legion back. You'll have to subdue it first, of course, but I don't imagine it's anything you can't handle.
Thank you.
Marvelous, marvelous work. I almost envy your power.
Come on, Jin. You're slowing down, man. Keep up.
Yeah. Damn.
All right, good job. That's enough. Let's take a breather.
Oh, sorry. Captain, looks like I'm still no match for you.
That's nothing to be ashamed of, Jin. Just means you got more growing to do. You'll get stronger. You're gonna have to.
Yes, sir. Yeah, it's just, you're always coming in and bailing me out. Someday, I want to return the favor.
Don't worry about me, Jin. You can wipe my own ass. You know, my kids just got accepted into criminal affairs. Both of them.
No way. Wow! The twins! They sure grow up fast, huh?
Yeah. And I'm not getting any younger either. Don't try to argue with me. I know I'm not the same guy I used to be. Anyway, what I'm trying to say is, look, if anything happens to me, I need you around to look out for them. Right? They know you. They'll listen to you.
Oh, well, of course. But wait, Captain. Just don't go anywhere until I get a little stronger, okay? Wait and see. Soon I'll be strong enough to take care of all three of you. That's right. I should be getting back to training.
Yeah, you got it. I appreciate it, Jin.
Cap?
Oh. Okay, it's you.
Wait, where'd it go? Damn. Nice job. Here, I promised Max I'd look out for you. Oh, you know, you remind me more and more of Max every time I look at you. But, well, not that you look like him or anything. But there's no doubt about it. You're his kid. Anything he put his mind to, anything, he'd pull it off. And I saw that in you. I saw it just now. I've lost count of how many... I knew your dad for years. And I still feel like there's a lot more I could have learned from him.
Hey! Come on! Aren't you forgetting someone? Hello? Little help over here?
Oh, jeez. Alicia? All right, hang tight. I'll be right there. No. Okay. Sorry. Looks like you're gonna have to help Alicia out, too.
You could use the Arm Legion now, right?
Thanks for getting me out of there. granted, it's that Legion's fault I was under there in the first place. Akira went on ahead after Jenna. You'd better go too. You're the only one still fit enough to help out. Don't worry about me and Jin, we'll be fine. Go find Akira.
is Akira. I found Jenna. She's on the top floor, somewhere called Azure Plaza. She's tough. Wait, what the hell is that?
What? What is it?
Whatever it is, it's absorbing chimeras.
What? I see now. So you weren't just biding your time.
The suspect is Jenna Anderson. Whatever she's planning, she must be stopped. If she won't come in peace, you have my authorization to stop her by whatever means necessary.
Roger!
Watch out! She's not human! How sad. This is how you live, following orders without question, without thought. And you call yourselves human.
Give yourself up, Jenna, and we'll talk about it back at the station.
Maybe you're happy with your lot, but a word of advice.
Give it up. Come along quietly.
Your power is not the gift you think it is. One day, it will cost you everything.
Control chimeras will only go so far.
So you two are... I see. As for you, you'll make a fine trial run.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm with Akira. It's a... I'm gonna administer first aid.
I couldn't...
Hey, just zip it.
A medical chopper is on its way to the mall. Bring anyone who needs medical attention to the front entrance. All Neuron officers still in the mall, report back to HQ ASAP. Repeat, all officers return to HQ.
Okay, Akira's heartbeat is stable. Looks like the worst is over. But to be completely honest, it's a miracle they made it out in the first place.
Thanks to Dr. Calvert, he's a miracle worker.
I can't take all the credit. Our Akira is quite special.
There is still a chance of infection. Run another check, and make sure there's no sign of mutation.
Brenda, we can take it from here. Go back to HQ and let everyone know Akira is safe.
But, Doctor...
Brenda, please. I'll be here to make sure everything goes smoothly. And either way, I have more than enough work to keep me busy around here for quite some time. Thank you.
I see. Very well. I'll see you at the station, Doctor.
Brenda and the Commander are both on it. Akira literally couldn't be in better hands. Brenda gives even the Commander a run for his money when it comes to all that science stuff. And what happened to Akira wasn't your fault. Jenna was more powerful than anyone could have expected. Trust me, even the Commander didn't see it coming. Akira did what she did because it's her duty as a Neuron officer to protect you, no matter what. But duty is one thing. To go that far for you, Akira must really have wanted to keep you safe. You've both been through so much, and Akira's taken it harder than you have. But putting her brother first? I guess that's sisterly love. Having someone you'd do anything to protect like that must... Oh, never. That's right. We got a report back from the high-tech forensics department. That huge thing you fought at the mall? Apparently, it wasn't a Chimera at all. They've never seen anything that wasn't a Chimera spread data corruption like that. They're all completely stumped. Well, if they figure anything out, you'll know about it as soon as I do. Beyond that, we're putting all our effort into finding out where Jenna went. She completely vanished 20 years ago, and now she's back. And with that thing in tow, not even the commander has any clue what she's after. And that's a rarity for him. As if your hands weren't full enough with the Chimeras, right? Jenna's not going to make things any easier. Brenda!
I'm glad I found you two. I just got back from the lab. She's going to be fine. Akira is shockingly resilient, really. Akira's still under anesthesia, but why don't you go pay a visit? The facility is usually off-limits to outside personnel, but this time, I think we can make an exception. Take your time and collect yourself. Find me in the infirmary when you're ready.
Brenda, thank you. Well, that's a load off my mind. I've got to get back to work. Let me know if you need anything, okay?
We'll be right back. keeping up the good work, I see. Ah, there's something we need to talk about. Can you spare me an ear? Preferably two. So, I have to confess. Oh, before that... Oh, wow! It's a perfect fit! And it really suits you. Oh, isn't it great? It's like I'm looking at the real Lappy! Oh, speaking of... Okay. Right, there's something I have to tell you. It's about Lappy. He's been me. I am Lappy. There it is. I'm sorry. I know. I should have told you earlier. You know, you are handling this a lot better than I expected. I thought you were gonna freak out, oh, it can't be! How could you, Marie? Oh, I never knew the difference, Nothing? Huh. Okay. Well, before I came to Neuron, I was a traffic officer. That's how I became Lappy. I'd put on that suit and walk around, and everyone would smile at me. Oh, best feeling ever. And everyone here always looks so tired, you know? So, well, I figured a visit from Lappy would get them smiling again. It went so well the first time, so I just kept doing it, and now look, Lappy's a part of the Neuron family! Which brings me to our problem. Last week, I put the suit on, fell flat on my face, and twisted my ankle. I know. And now Brenda says to give Lappy a rest. Huh. Brenda figured out it was me. Anyway, I can't be Lappy again until my stupid leg is healed up. Meanwhile, Neuron gets gloomier and gloomier. And at this rate, the whole office will be plunged into endless darkness. We cannot let that happen. And so, in the meantime, I want you to be Lappy in my place. It is the perfect plan. Nobody knows it's me in there. Just wear it and just talk to anyone who could use a friendly smile. I'm sure they're going to love you. Okay, don't worry. Just think of all the good you'll be doing. I'm getting gloomy vibes from all around the station. First of all, yes, the B2 elevators. There's gotta be people in need of a Lappy-sized pick-me-up. What are you waiting for? Go turn those frowns around so there are smiles instead.
Marie, what do you...
carefree as ever, I see. Look, I kind of want to be alone now. Could you be a little less here? Huh? You want to know what's troubling me? Well, I don't know if talking about it'll help, but sure. You know, I really love animals, especially cats. But protecting cats from Redshift isn't part of the job, so I can't get clearance to do it. I gotta do something about it, but I don't want to get the sack. But then I imagine all the poor cats out there, sick and scared in some alley. It keeps me awake at night. Really? You know a place where cats can stay safe? Wow, I had no idea there was somewhere like that out in Mason Forest. You've got to take me sometime. If too many people go to see it, it'll attract too much attention. Yeah, I guess that makes sense. But it's a load off my mind just knowing it's out there. Hey, Marie, hey, Lappy, thanks a lot for listening.
I heard everything! Oh, that's one more smile we'll see around the station today. On to the next troubled soul. They're in the infirmary. This'll be the happiest place on the Ark in...
Iris, startup Iris, shut down.
Oh, Marie, sorry, Lappy. I'm kind of going through some stuff right now. Can you... are you trying to cheer me up? I appreciate the thought. In fact, it's my partner Avery I'm all wound up about. Avery's really energetic, which is great, but just look at me. Not so much. I can't jump back into action right away, after a mission. Hell, I get winded just standing up for a long time. To be honest, sometimes I'm not even sure why they chose me for Neuron. But Avery won't hear any of it. I really can't keep going on like this. I've tried to tell her, but come on, you know her. I literally can't get a word in edgewise. There's no way I'll ever keep up with her. Please, Lappy, would you please tell Avery for me? Don't tell her, but, indirectly. She's probably in the break room. And thanks for doing what I can't.
Taking a breather? Let me guess, you're here for an energy drink? Something like that? Wow, I bet it's exhausting to wear that thing all day. Your little hat! Wearing your little hat all day must be exhausting, Lappy. But forget it. You're thirsty, yeah? Well, today I recommend a nice alkali coca. One sip and you will literally burst with energy like boom, 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 bam! I've had three. Woo! Come on, try one and see! Oh, you didn't come here for a drink, did you? Wait, what's that, boy? There's a Neuron officer lacking self-confidence, says he can't keep up with me? Oh, you're talking about Mitsuru, aren't you? Yeah, he's been even gloomier than usual since we got back from Ark Mall. Of course I noticed. But, bending over backwards so he can keep up won't do us any good either. If anything, I've been overdoing it, hoping some of my energy would rub off. I guess I've been pretty hard on him. Sorry to get kind of dark there. I get wound up pretty easily. I'll try to pace myself so I won't push Mitsuru too hard. It's an alkali coca. Hopefully it'll cheer Mitsuru up.
Hi, Marie. Dang it. I mean, hi, Lappy. So, what'd she say? What's this? Alkali cocoa? Oh, so Avery was just trying to motivate me by acting so wild all the time, huh? I never noticed that she even cared. And here I am just moping around alone. That settles it. I've got to get stronger. I won't drag Avery down anymore. But first, I need to apologize to her for the misunderstanding. In person. You know, I feel a little braver already. Thanks to you, Lappy! Oh, we're so close.
Excellent job! Oh, Mitsuru and Avery? Now that's a twofer. You know, I'm starting to think there really is a real Lappy. Okay, there's just one more officer in need of some Lappy time. They're in the training room on level B3. Now go spread some cheer.
What is it? Oh, it's you, Marie. Right, Lappy, yeah. I don't see you down here much. Look, I'm in the middle of training. Whatever it is, could you save it? Hey, I told you I'm training. Could you please come back later? What is it? You are extra persistent today. You want to know why I'm down here training so hard? What's it to you? Alright, look. The truth is, I need to get stronger. Akira's still unconscious after what went down at the mall. With the captain gone, that's on me. Max isn't here anymore. Well, that means while we're on the job, his kids are my responsibility. I promised him I'd take care of them. Now, I don't know if I'm strong enough to keep that promise. But now, he's gone. And I'm not any stronger. I couldn't even catch up to Jenna in the first place. Akira could. And look what I let happen. I couldn't face Max if he came back. Not like this. So, I'll do anything to get stronger. And fast. I have to keep everybody safe. I can't let him down. I know I don't have the experience or the skill that he had. I figure maybe I can make up for it with sheer effort. Wait, what's that? What? You're saying you want to spar? Well, thanks for the laugh. No, no, but seriously, you've never lifted an ex-baton in your life, right? Oh, that stance. Yeah, I see. You're serious about this. Oh, okay then. But I'm warning you. Come on, show me what you've got.